Hello, my name is Jerome McDonough. I'm an associate professor here in the Graduate School of Library and Information Science. My specialty is focused on digital preservation and on metadata, and in particular on the sort of combination of social and technical factors that affect how well we can actually support long-term preservation of digital materials as well as provide access to them. The thing that really inspired me in terms of trying to work on digital preservation issues is I wanted to see us avoid having this happen to digital data. So this is an old Edison cylinder that met a very unfortunate end one day. If you look closely at that side, you'll see a bunch of very teeny tiny little grooves, which used to be a sound recording. You would have one of these, you would mount it on a special platform that would rotate the cylinder, and you'd have a stylus that would sit on it and play it back. But this is an exemplar of information does not take care of itself. So unless we are very proactive in how we treat information, we're going to find in 100 years that a lot of very important data from the early 21st century has been lost forever. My current research is focusing on preservation of computer games and interactive software of various kinds, particularly educational software. We don't really have a good idea of how to preserve interactive experiential materials. So by looking at how we can preserve something like Doom or the Oregon Trail or Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego, we're not just preserving computer games, we're also figuring out how do we solve the problem of preserving complex multimedia interactive works generally. So what we learn about preserving Carmen Sandiego, we can turn around and use to preserve the software systems that people are using to do genomic studies, to do climate studies, software people are using to manipulate GIS information. I think the contribution I'm making to the study of digital preservation is trying to clarify the social relationships that have to happen for digital preservation to happen successfully. It's not just the technology. There's a culture surrounding game use, and when we are trying to preserve these complex software artifacts, we find sometimes we can't do it perfectly. And then the question is, what's vital to preserve? And in those cases, we can't just answer that as curators and digital preservationists. We have to think about who in the community cares about this material and how do we set up systems to allow a curator to communicate with game designers, gamers, game researchers, collect the information they need to make decisions about what's important to preserve here and make sure it's preserved.